arms when we walk. You'll notice when you walk, your arms swing in the opposite direction from your legs. When my left leg goes forward, my right arm swings forward. When my right leg goes forward, my left arm goes forward. That's a natural movement that is not generated by forcing the swing of the arms. It actually comes because of the rotation of the torso. So let's talk about the rotation of the torso and how that affects our walking. A lot of people, or probably most people, think of walking as being generated by something below the hips. But in fact, most of what we do when we're walking, or a lot of it at least, is coming from our abdominal core, not just from what's below our hips. And so we need to be aware of what's happening with the abdomen when we walk in order to really understand what's going on. And this is what's going to play into the swing of the arms. So when I walk, what's happening is I have rotation of my upper torso, which is guided by my upper abdominal muscles, turning my thoracic spine. So the thoracic spine is in the spine behind the chest. It is rotated by my upper abdominal muscles. So I have upper abdominal muscles on the left, and they turn my body to the right. I have upper abdominal muscles on the right, and they turn my body to the left. My arms are attached to my upper abdomen, so when I rotate back and forth using my upper abdominal muscles, it creates a swing of the arm naturally, even though my arms are really just hanging there doing nothing. It's the rotation of the core that is moving them side to side. So why, when we walk, are the arms not swinging side to side? Why are they swinging forward and back? That is because of the rotation of the lower abdominal muscles. The lower abdominal muscles rotate my lumbar spine from one side to the other. And I can think of that almost as like my belly button pulling back and to the right. That's activation of my right lower abdominal muscles, or the right lower abs. They pull my lumbar spine to the right, and they also tuck my pelvis on the right side at the same time. If I want to shift my weight over to the left leg, I turn my lower abdominal muscles to the left, so I think of my belly button turning to the left and tucking my pelvis on the left side. When we walk, we use what we call, or what I call, torsional rotation of the abdominal core, meaning my upper abdominal muscles are turning in the opposite direction from my lower abdominal muscles. That creates torsion, which is a twisting action, like twisting a towel. So one end turns in one direction, the other end turns in the opposite direction. My upper hand is turning clockwise, my lower hand is turning counterclockwise. That's torsion. So torsion, when we refer to the waist or the abdominal muscles, means my right upper abdominal muscles turn in the opposite direction from my right lower abdominal muscles. And my left upper abdominal muscles turn in the opposite direction from my left lower abdominal muscles. When they activate together, I have torsion on the left. My left upper torso is turning clockwise. My left lower torso is turning counterclockwise. When I activate torsion on the right, now I have my right upper torso turning counterclockwise and my right lower torso turning clockwise. When I shift my weight back and forth, I'm activating torsion on the left, then torsion on the right, then torsion on the left, then torsion on the right. Now, what I haven't mentioned as part of this whole body movement is the action of the hip joints, which necessarily have to coordinate with the upper abdominal motion. So when I do torsion on the left, I'm flexing my right hip. And that allows me to move my whole weight over to the left. When I say flexing the right hip, I mean I am lifting my knee upwards on the right side. That's flexion of the right hip. You can't see the knee lift because as I start to lift the knee up and I use the torsional rotation of the left, that upward lift really just allows me to carry my weight to the left. Now when I go to the right, I'm going to use torsion on the right, and as I lift my left hip, or my left knee using flexion in the left hip, it allows me to lift my weight over to the right. And so I'm coordinating motion of my hip joints and the torsional rotation of the core to shift my weight to the right, to the left, to the right, and to the left. My arms swing forward and back because the upper torso is turning in the opposite direction